Okay. Well, welcome. So first of all, I wanted to go over because you have not heard our little rules of our group, right? We have rules, but they're really super easy to follow. So number one, you move how you move. So your body is uniquely made and created, and it moves uniquely, and that is beautiful. So the other rule goes along with that. We are only allowed to look at our neighbor if we are looking at them to tell them they're doing a good job. Okay? So we are not comparing anything. You move how you move, and as long as you're moving, you're doing it right. If you need to take any rest at all, you go ahead and take a rest. If we're doing something standing and your legs are getting tired or something, go ahead and sit down and do something else. Okay? It's not about keeping up. It's not about weight. It's not about anything like that. Okay? It's about using our bodies the way that they were designed to worship and honor the one who created them. Okay? It's not Zumba.
It was yoga. The Zumba that was doing something different all the time because I never heard
Yes.
Zumba.
Yes. Zumba classes are fun. They really are, but they can be a little intense. So, for today's workout, for anyone who's watching later too, for today's workout, you do need a pair of drumsticks or wooden spoons or something that you can bang against something else. So, drumsticks and two light weights. We're using water bottles today, something around 1 to 3 pounds, doesn't have to be heavy. Okay? All right, so then we are all set to go. We'll open in prayer and get moving. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the opportunity to get together tonight. Help us, Lord, to use our bodies and to move our bodies the way that you have designed them to be. Lord, you made these bodies good. And we want to celebrate them tonight as we move them. And we want to honor you and glorify you in all that we do here. Lord, we ask you to come into this place, to be with us, Lord, and to accept this movement time as an offering to you. Lord, we thank you for all that you've given to us. We thank you for all that you do to us, for us, and through us. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so we're gonna start warming up standing up. Okay, make sure you got a little bit of space. So the first thing we're going to do is stepping and touching across. Okay?
Case closed.
Good. You don't have to do anything with the arms if you don't want to. Good. You can snap if you want to. If you're like my 5-year-old, he hasn't quite figured out how to do that yet. And now we're walking. Good. You don't have to move. Just marching in place. Getting everything warmed up. Then reach out, in, out, in, out, in, out, in, and we walk. So that's going to be repeated throughout the song. That same pattern, okay? Spread your feet wide. We're going to reach. Good, nice, good stretch to the side of your body. Now we go overhead. Reach. Good. I love this part. And we walk. Get ready to step out. Reach. Reach. Up and up. I changed it a little bit on you. Switch sides. So we're moving in and out of this stretch a little bit. Come up tall. Get ready to walk. Walk if you want to. and backward, or in a circle, however you want. Step out, out, up overhead, and out, 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 up, up. Good job. This is one of my new favorite songs. I love it. Keep going. Almost done. One more time through. There you go. All right. It gets your heart rate up a little bit. Gets you moving a little bit. Stay standing. We're getting our cardio out of the way right away, and then we're doing the straightening, okay? So this one, we're gonna start stepping out, out, in. Okay? Out, out. Out, out. Out, out. Out, out. Out, out. Good. Get ready to clap. Clap. About the fall of man and the fact that God gave man a choice, and that choice led to the fall of mankind, meaning man chose disobedience and to not obey God. And what that did was that caused a separation, that caused a wedge, a wall to be built between man and God that wasn't there before and wasn't meant to be there. So that was a rough week. This week we're on the other side of that, and we're talking about provision. So we are talking today about God's provision for his people after the fall, even though he wouldn't have had to provide, he continues. So we will continue with that as we go along. But we've got some working out to do. I'm going to run you through the exercises we're going to do, and then we will do 30. seconds of each exercise. We will do three exercises, 30 seconds right in a row without a rest, and then we're gonna have a 45 second break, okay? Then we're gonna do it all over again, and then we'll have a 45 second break, and we'll do it all over again, okay? All right, now, at any point in time, if you feel like you're not able to keep the proper posture or form, drop these water bottles, okay? They won't break anything, so drop them, all right? First thing we're going to do, we're starting the hands by our sides, and we're coming up. Then I want you to turn, come up overhead, come down, turn. If you don't get the turning exactly right, that's okay, all right? It just gets the muscles in a little bit different way. So that's all we're doing for our first move, okay? From there, we're gonna have arms out, and you're gonna come in, squeeze the shoulder blades. Modifications for this one, drop the weight, or elbows bent, that's fine too. All right, very last exercise, you're going to come out here in front of you, and we're just going to pulse, little pulses up. That might get a little bit tiring by then, so if it does, drop those water bottles, okay? Most important thing is that you're able to keep upright posture, your spine is staying straight, and your shoulders are staying out of your ears, okay? All right, here we go. Here we go. Lift, turn. Good. Nice, easy pace. Focusing more on form than we do on how many we do or how fast we go. Have you do something a little bit different. I just want you to come up and down. We're not going to hold it out here, okay? arms in this position as opposed to thumbs up works our shoulder a little bit differently. In a way it doesn't often get worked, but it needs to be. 8 seconds left and we're done with our second round. We're almost through this. Very good, and a rest. The arms are burning. So, we are not going to cover every single event of the Bible because that we would be here for, 6,000 years if we did that. So we're going to jump ahead a little bit today, but we're talking about an overall theme of God providing for his people. And if you take a look through all of the Bible, but especially the Old Testament, God repeatedly provides for his people in situations that seem absolutely impossible, and he provides. And I find it interesting that 365 times, go ahead and come up again, 365 times in the Bible, God mentions, fear not. 365 times. Most of the time, when you see fear not, it is accompanied by something that either says directly or means, I am with you. So God tells us 365 times to fear not because he is with us. He will provide for every possible need. Now when I say that, he will provide for our needs, that doesn't necessarily mean that he will provide for all of our wants. But he will make sure that we have what we need when we need it. And I think about when God had Moses lead the Israelites out of Egypt. And first of all, huge provision. He parted the Red Sea so his people could go across on dry land. That was a provision if I've ever seen a provision. But aside from that, as they were wandering on a journey where they had no idea really where they were going, he was providing their way, their direction, their guidance the whole time. But not only that, he provided them with food, with manna, every day, in the amount that they needed. Not an amount to be saved up and stored away and hoarded and stop. Good job, we're done with that one. Okay. So we've got one more kind of circuit, and this is going to be geared more toward our core. Our core is anything from here to here, okay? So we're going to work our belly muscles, we're going to work our back muscles, we're going to work our leg muscles through this one, okay? It's going to have the same 30 seconds of each exercise. We're going to follow the same pattern. The first exercise we're going to do, you can either have your hands here or you can have them here. We're going to do crisscrosses. Okay, so that's exercise one. Exercise two, you will probably recognize because we've done this one before. We're gonna do our little teapot, okay? Exercise three is sitting to standing. With this one, I just ask that you do it with control, okay? No, no more falling into the chair. We're not doing that. All right. Here we go. So crisscrosses first. Either hands up by your ears or hands here. Either way, you're not pulling on your head or your neck. Very good. This rotational movement is something we tend to lose as we get older, and it's very, very beneficial for us to be able to move in this pattern. Good. And then, little teapot. So here, we're keeping our shoulders back. We're staying up nice and tall, but we're just tilting to the side. If it helps, you can sit a little bit more toward the front of your chair. That way your hands can glide right along the legs of the chair. Very good. Excellent. Sit to stand. Again, you go at your own pace here. As long as you're moving, you're doing it right. Very good. These big muscles in our legs need to be worked. works. We've got to carry us around everywhere we go. So if, when you're outside of here, you're finding yourself tending to use your hands to help yourself a lot to get out of chairs, stop. Stop doing that. Don't do that. Our little arm muscles are not meant for that. Our big arm or big leg muscles are meant to do that job. Yeah, so don't cheat yourself by using your hands, unless you're in a super low seat that you really can't get out of. But all right, we've got about 20 seconds left here. I want to read you guys the scripture that we're following as our main scripture for today, and that's Isaiah 41:10. So Isaiah 41:10 says, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." And we twist. This is one of the many places in God's word that he reminds us that he is with us. He's with us when things are going well. He's with us when things are not going so well. He's with us when we have no idea what's going on, and we're confused, and we're hurting. Good. Using those side muscles, pull yourself up and control yourself down. Very good. Sit to stand. It is definitely warm in here. Last little bit of work, and then cool down. arc out, and we're going to go to our right first, okay? We're going to come over, pull, over, open, over, pull, over, open.
Are we supposed to keep the
Oh, yes. Yep, we are keeping the pointy hands down. Okay, so we're going to do a little bit of stretching. We're going to stretch the arms and your legs. Everything did a lot of work, so we're going to stretch everything out, and then we're going to have a time of just kind of relaxing and just spending time being present with him. Okay? So one leg out in front of you, and keeping our back nice and straight, you're going to hinge forward at your hips just to get a stretch in the back of that straight leg. It's always amazing for me when I think of how God has provided for his people and how many times his people have turned away from him and how many times, you know, we've disobeyed, and man, we don't get it right, you know, and go ahead and switch legs. And yet time and time again, he not only offers, but he pleads with his people to turn toward him. He says many times, just turn to me, just turn to me, and I will give you more than you can imagine. And switch again. Just knowing that he's provided for so many people through so many different times. You think of Noah. During his time of 75 years of building the ark, go ahead and switch your legs. Noah built that ark during a time where there was a drought, and people thought he was crazy. Why are you building a boat? There's no water here. And Noah, with his life and through his words, continued to minister to people. In his obedience in building the ark, he ministered to people. Go ahead and reach across. Pull that arm towards your chest. So go ahead and come underneath your arm. You can grab your elbow. But in response to Noah's obedience, God did provide. And God saved Noah and his family. Not because, you know, nobody else was invited on the boat. That wasn't the case. Noah witnessed to people, ministered to people through his life, and nobody took him up on it, essentially. And I can just imagine during that time when those waters start to rise and people realize that they had a choice to make. But by the time they realized they had a choice to make, it was too late to make that choice any different. And he gives us the same choices. We just don't have a big boat and a big flood coming our way, but we still have the same choices. So if you can, I want you to take one ankle across the other knee and pull that knee toward your opposite shoulder. So you're going to stretch kind of the outside of the hip, the butt area. It's a good stretch. Yes. even the most perfect of perfect people who have ever lived on this planet do not come close to being holy enough, righteous enough to be able to come into his presence. And so for God to do the ultimate provision, to provide to us, you know, as sinners, as fallen people who make mistakes and disobey him regularly, for him to provide a way for us to be with him, it's miraculous. That's the best word. I'm kind of speechless on that one. So I want you to find a nice, comfortable position. However that may be, I have a mic pack in the back of my back. So just a nice, relaxed position. Go ahead and put your hands in your lap. And let's just take some deep breaths. As you breathe in, I want you to breathe in, fear not. Breathe out, for I am with you. Breathe in, fear not. Breathe out, for I am with you. Father, we come before you, a broken people, who desire nothing more than to be close to you. Lord, we're so thankful that you want to be close to us. Lord, the people that have chosen to walk away from you, the people who have chosen to disobey you many, many times. And Lord, you keep your arms stretched out wide and you provide a way. All you ask is that we turn and that we come toward you, that we choose you with that free will that you gave to us. And all you ask of us is that we turn toward you and that we choose you. And you will bring us in with arms open wide. You will provide for our every single need. Lord, we thank you for the provision that you have given to all of our ancestors. We thank you for the provision that you have given to us and to those that we know and love. Lord, we thank you for the provision that you have provided through your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, that he was placed on this earth, that he was humbled to be the lowest of the low, to be one of us, born in a manger, not brought up in a rich, fancy palace or anything like that, but brought up just like the rest of us, Lord, and that he felt everything that we have felt, that he experienced everything that we have experienced. Lord, and that he chose to walk with us. Not only did he choose to walk with us, but he chose to die for us. It was a choice that he made. And in this way that you provided for us to be wiped clean, to be holy and righteous in your sight, Lord, we thank you that when you look at us, you see him. Though everything that we do is just minuscule and like dirty rags compared to you and what you are and what you're capable of doing. Lord, we thank you so much for the love that you have poured out on us through your Son. Lord, and we ask that you would fill us with that love, with that grace, so that we can overflow onto those around us. Lord, as we go through the rest of our week, may you provide for others by using us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I love this song. If there's any other stretching you feel like you need to do, you go right ahead. I'm gonna keep this song going because I love it.